and gentlemen, and welcome to the Cape May County Technical High School show, All in the Time, by David Ives. Our runtime this evening will be 1 hour. If you haven't already done so, please stow your carry-on luggage underneath your seat. Please take your seat, fasten your seatbelt, and make sure that your seat back and folding tray are in their full upright position. We remind you that this is a non-smoking play. Smoking is prohibited on the entire campus, including the laboratories. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying the laboratory smoke detectors is prohibited by law. There are several emergency exits in this auditorium, including the backs and sides of the auditorium. Please take a moment now to locate your nearest exit. Remember, it may be behind you. Your portable electronic devices must be set to silent mode. If you have to make a phone call during our show, please don't. Your seats also double as a flotation device in the case of a water landing. No, they don't. If necessary, an oxygen mask will automatically appear in front of you. Place it firmly over your nose and mouth and scream quietly, I mean, breathe normally. When the captain dims the lights, take your seat, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Thank you. Yes, it is.
Sorry.
Sure thing.
Excuse me, is this seat taken?
Excuse me?
Is this taken?
No, but I'm expecting someone in a minute.
Thanks anyway.
Sure thing.
Excuse me, is this seat taken?
No, but I'm expecting someone very shortly.
Or do you mind if I sit here until at least here it comes?
Did you seem to be pretty late?
No, you might be turned down.
Sorry, nice try though.
Sure thing. Hey, is this seat taken?
No, it's not.
Mind if I sit here?
Yes, I would.
Is this seat taken?
No, it's not.
Mind if I sit here?
No, go ahead.
Thanks. Every place else seems to be taken.
Mm-hmm.
Great place.
Mm-hmm.
What's the book?
I just wanted to read in quiet, if you don't mind.
No, sure thing. Every place else seems to be taken.
Mm-hmm.
Great place for reading.
Yeah, I like it.
What's the book?
The Sound of Fury.
Ooh, Hemingway. What's the book?
The Sound of Fury.
Ooh, Faulkner.
Have you read it?
Not actually. I should write a lot about it. It's supposed to be great.
It is great.
I hear it's great. Waiter. What's the book?
The Sound of Fury.
Ooh, Faulkner.
Have you read it?
I'm a Mets fan myself.
Have you read it?
Yeah, I read it in college.
Ooh, where was college?
Oral Roberts University.
Where was college?
Actually, I was lying. I never really went to college. I just like to party! Ooh, yeah!
Where was college?
Harvard.
Do you like Faulkner?
I love Faulkner. I spent a whole winter reading him once.
I've just started.
I was so excited after the first 10 pages of reading, I went out and bought everything he ever wrote. One of the greatest reading experiences of my entire life. I mean, all that incredible psychological understanding, page after page of gorgeous prose, the way he grasps the mystery of time and human existence, the smells of the earth. What do you think?
I think it's pretty boring.
What's the book?
The Sound of Fury.
Ooh, Faulkner.
Do you like Faulkner?
I love Faulkner.
He's incredible.
I spent a whole winter reading him once.
I got so excited after reading the first 10 pages that I went out and bought everything else he ever wrote.
All that incredible psychological understanding.
And the prose is so gorgeous.
And the way he grasps the mystery in time.
And human existence. I can't believe I've waited this long to read him.
You never know. You might not like him at first.
That's true.
You might not have been ready for him. You gotta do things at the right time or it's just no good.
That's happened to me.
It's all in the timing. My name's Bill, by the way.
I'm Betty.
Hi.
Hi.
I thought reading Faulkner was a great experience.
Yep.
The Sound of Fury.
Onwards and upwards.
Waiter, you gotta do these things at the right time or it's just no good.
That's happened to me.
It's all in the timing. My name's Bill, by the way.
I'm Betty.
Do you come here a lot?
I'm actually just in town for 2 days from Pakistan.
Oh. Pakistan.
My name is Bill, by the way.
I'm Betty.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you come here a lot?
Every now and again. Do you?
No. Not as much as I used to. Not before my nervous breakdown.
So, do you come here a lot?
Why are you asking?
I'm just interested.
Are you really interested, or just want to pick me up?
No, I'm really interested.
Why would you be interested in whether I come here a lot?
I'm just getting acquainted.
Maybe you're only interested for the sake to make small just long enough to ask me back to your place. Those are some music, or because you just rented this great DVD, or you've got some terrific Unknown Smiths record. Only, all you want to do is take me home, and while you're there, you'll pat into the kitchen, grab yourself a soda, or ask if you or I like anything, and then you'll proceed to sit back down beside me, confess to me that you've got a girlfriend named Stephanie, who's away at med school in Belgium for a year, and who you've been involved with, off and on what you've described as a very intricate relationship for the past 7 years, none of which interests me, mister.
Do you come here?
Every so often.
You know, I come in quite a bit, and I don't remember seeing you.
You must be into the schedules.
Misconnections.
Yes, different time zones.
It is amazing how you live right next door to someone's town and never even know it.
I know.
See, like...
It's crazy.
We probably pass each other in the street right in front of this place every day. Probably.
Yep.
This waiter seems to be on some different time zone. I can't seem to locate one anywhere. Waiter! So do you,
I beg your pardon?
Nothing.
Must be on different schedules.
Misconnections.
Yes, different time zones.
It is amazing how I could live right next door to someone in this town and never even know it.
I know.
See, like...
It's crazy.
Hey, you weren't waiting for anyone when I came here, were you?
Actually, I was.
Oh, boyfriend?
Sort of.
What's a sort of boyfriend?
My husband.
Oh. Hey, you weren't waiting for anyone when I came here, were you?
Actually, I was.
Oh, boyfriend?
Sort of.
What's a sort of boyfriend?
We were meeting here just to break up!
What's a sort of boyfriend?
My lover. Oh, here she comes right now!
Hey, you weren't waiting for anyone when I came here, were you?
No, just reading.
Kind of a sad patient for a Friday night. Reading here in a place like this?
Do you think so?
I mean... Sure. What's a good-looking girl like you doing alone in a place like this?
Trying to keep away from minds like that.
No, listen. Hey, you weren't waiting for anyone when I came here, were you?
No, just reading.
What's a good-looking girl like you doing alone in a place like this?
This is actually my first night alone in quite a while.
Oh.
You see, I just recently ended a relationship.
Oh.
Of rather long-standing.
I'm sorry.
Listen, since you're reading here by yourself, it's such a sad place for a Friday night. Would you like to go elsewhere?
Nope.
Do something else.
I don't think so.
Let's head out to the movies in a little bit.
No.
Great chance left, Faulkner catch his breath. All those long sentences do get him pretty tired.
Thanks anyway. I appreciate the invitation.
Sure thing.
So, you weren't waiting for anyone when I came here, were you?
No, just reading.
Kind of sad place for a Friday night, reading here all alone.
I like to think of it as existentially romantic, you know? Cappuccino, great literature, rainy night.
Well, works in Paris, but we could find a cafe, hop on Concorde, catch a plane.
I'm a little short on plane fare tonight.
Darn it, so am I.
To tell you the truth, I was headed to the movies after I finished the section. Would you like to come along, since you can't seem to locate a waiter?
It sounds like a nice offer, but...
Girlfriend?
Well, two actually, one is pregnant, and Stephanie!
Girlfriend?
No. Not unless you mean that castrating chick I dumped last night!
Girlfriend?
Sorta.
What's a sort of girlfriend?
My mother. I just ended a relationship, actually.
Oh.
Of rather long standing.
I'm sorry to hear it.
This is my first night out in a long time, and tell you the truth, I'm a little bit at sea.
Oh, so you didn't stop to talk to me because you're a loony or got some weird political affiliation?
No, straight down ticket Republican. Straight down ticket Democrat. Can I tell you something about politics? I like to consider myself a citizen of the universe. I'm unaffiliated.
That's a relief, so am I.
I vote with my beliefs.
Labels are not important.
Labels are not important. Take me, for example. So if I had 2 points, 3 points, 4.0 in college if I came from Pittsburgh, Cleveland, Westchester County.
Sure.
I believe a man is who he is.
I believe a person is who he is. I believe a person is who they are?
I think so, too.
So what if I'm Mark Trotsky? So what if I throw by a liposuction? So what if I don't have a... So what if I join the Peace Corps? I was acting on my convictions.
Sure.
You just can't hang a sign on somebody.
Exactly. I'll bet you're a Scorpio. To tell you the truth, I was headed to the movies after I finished this section. Would you like to come along?
Sounds interesting. What's playing?
A couple of the really early Woody Allen movies.
Oh.
You don't like Woody Allen?
Sure I like Woody Allen.
But you're not, like, crazy about Woody Allen.
Some of those early ones kind of get my nerves.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
I was headed out to the movies in a little bit.
So was I.
The Woody Allen Festival?
Just up the street.
Do you like those really early ones?
I think anyone who doesn't ought to run off the planet.
How many times have you seen Bananas?
8 times.
12. So are you still interested in going to the movies?
Do you like Entenmann's crumb cake?
I went out at 2 in the morning just to get some. Did you have an Etch-a-Sketch as a child?
Yes. And do you like Brussels sprouts?
No, I find them disgusting.
They are disgusting.
Do you believe marriage played current sentiment against it?
Yes.
And children?
3 of them.
2 girls and a boy.
Harvard Master and Brown.
And will you love me?
Yes.
And cherish me forever?
Yes.
And do you still want to go to the movies?
Sure thing.
Where?
I'm feeling I'm early. I'm glad you're early, too. Well, sort of. I was hoping to meet you here and get used to the room first. I get nervous in new places and with new people. I get nervous a lot. I brought you flowers. The flowers are a little wilted. I mean, they were pretty. I mean, there's this wonderful flower shop down the road, but I didn't have time to go there today. But I went a couple of days ago, and I wanted these flowers. I don't get a date every day, you know, and I just wanted this to be really great. So I got the best flowers that I could find, and I just want this to be special. You know what I mean?
What's with the mask?
Does it scare you?
No, it's just really weird.
So you're not gonna run off on me?
I have to admit, I'm a little curious. Why would you wear a mask at dinner?
My way of weeding out the losers. I want to find a guy who likes what I'm really like and doesn't let my looks get in the way.
Yeah, tell me about it.
You're not ugly.
I'm not?
Take off your glasses again. You have very pretty eyes.
Really? So do you.
Stop that.
Stop what?
No physical stuff now.
But you said my eyes and your eyes were pretty.
No.
But...
Shush.
Can I?
No.
Okay.
The flowers are very nice.
I like red. Do you like red?
Not much in the color.
Why is that?
They're so loaded. Red is passion, blue is sadness, green is envy.
It's good to feel something.
What?
At least the colors feel something. Black and white's so boring. There's no feeling at all.
Is that better, green beans?
Uh-huh.
That's my absolute favorite.
No way.
Nobody else likes these.
I do.
They're so good in that honey poppy seed sauce. You didn't. What are the odds we like the same things?
What else happens on these dates? You seem to have it pretty planned out with the mask and everything. It's like a test. I saw this one episode of Star Trek.
I love Star Trek.
Really?
Live long and prosper.
Earl Grey tea. Hot. So is this one of those tricky tests of the true nature of a species? What's the next trial?
Dinner.
I'll take that challenge. Already know what you're ordering?
Uh-huh.
Well, what are you having?
The secret.
Okay, I'll take your challenge.
What?
I'll take your dinner challenge.
Alright, how can I help y'all?
All of the usual.
And you?
I too will have the unusual usual on it.
You don't even know what it is.
I'm very brave. I'll try anything at least once.
It's very unusual.
I didn't see anything too unusual on the menu.
My usual isn't on the menu.
Oh.
Don't worry. It hasn't killed anyone. Yes. It is, however, responsible for my lovely appearance.
Well, I wouldn't want to look like that.
Oh, you bad man. You hurt my feelings.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
I'm just kidding. Relax.
Sorry, I get so nervous. Maybe I should wear a mask on dates.
You're doing well.
I think it's the mask. It's helping me too for some reason. So ridiculous. I guess it lightens the mood.
Ridiculous? Oh my, I'm ridiculous.
Oh no, you're very normal. The rest of us are weird.
Done too. There's
our order. Oh, that was quick. A hot dog?
A hot dog.
Most unusual.
It is. Who knows what's in the meat?
Well, I love hot dogs.
Really?
Yep.
I guess, I don't know, maybe, this is another test, isn't it? Oh, man.
Don't worry. I'm not this scary looking for real.
Okay.
I mean, I'm kind of ugly, but nothing like this.
Ugly?
Don't worry. I don't have a huge nose or weird messed up teeth or a gigantic mole on my face. I'm just not particularly good looking.
I mean, I don't really mind. I'm no William Shatner.
You sure?
I'm sure I'm not William Shatner.
You sure about the mask?
Yeah, I mean, I already know you have beautiful eyes.
Stop that.
I still can't compliment you?
No.
You don't have to take off the mask. It's okay.
No, I want to. You're really nice. You deserve to see my real face. You pass the best.
You're beautiful.
Stop.
You are, really?
No.
You don't have any reason to hide.
Do you want another hot dog?
Sure.
Baseball, but I'm a little bit confused. Before we get to St. Louis, will you remind me of the fellows' names on the team so that when we get to the ballpark, I won't be as confused?
All right. But you know, strange as it may seem, they give ball players nowadays very peculiar names.
Funny names?
You know, nicknames, pet names. All right, so on the St. Louis team, we've got who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
Oh, well, that's what I'm trying to find out. I want you to tell me the names of the fellows on the St. Louis team.
I'm telling you. Who's on first? What's on second? I don't know who's on third.
Do you know the fellows' names?
Yes.
Tell me who's playing first.
Yes.
I mean the guy on first base.
Who?
The fellow playing first for St. Louis.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who is on first?
Well, what are you asking me for?
I'm not asking you. I'm telling you. Who's on first?
I'm asking you who's on first.
Well, that's the man's name.
That's who's name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who is on first?
Have you got a first baseman on first?
Certainly.
Then tell me who's playing first.
Oh, absolutely.
When you pay off the first baseman every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it, and why not? The man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes.
So who gets it?
Why shouldn't he? You know, sometimes his wife comes down to collect it, though.
Whose wife?
Yes. And after all, the man earns it.
Who does?
Absolutely.
Look, all I'm trying to find out is what's the fella's name on first base?
Oh, no. What's the fella's name on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Well, who's on first?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
Well, don't change the players around.
I'm not changing nobody.
All right, now take it easy.
Right. Sorry. Now, what is the fella's name on first base?
What is the fella's name on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Well, who's on first?
I don't know.
He's on third, and we're not talking about him.
How did I get on third base?
You mentioned his name.
If I mentioned the third baseman's name, then who would I say is playing third?
Who is playing first?
Stay off of first, will you?
Well, what do you want me to do?
I want to know, what's the fellow's name on third base?
What is on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Well, who's on first?
I don't know.
He's on third.
There I go, back on third again.
Well, I can't change their names.
Will you please just stay on third base?
Please. Now, what do you want to know?
What is the fella's name on third base?
What is the fella's name on second base?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Well, who's on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
You got an outfield?
Oh, sure.
St. Louis has got a good outfield?
Oh, absolutely.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
I don't know. I just thought I'd ask you.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
Then tell me who's playing left field.
Who is playing first?
Stay out of the infield.
You won't mention any names out there.
I want to know, what's the fellow's name in left field?
What's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Well, who's on first?
I don't know. Third base.
All right. Take it easy. We're both just going to take it easy.
And the left fielder's name.
Why?
Because.
Oh, he's center field.
Wait. You got a pitcher on the team.
Now, wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
I don't know. Tell me the pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
You're not going to tell me today?
I'm telling you right now.
All right, go ahead and tell me.
Tomorrow.
Okay, what time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell me who's pitching?
All right, now listen. Who is not pitching? Who is
I'll
not...
I'll break your arm if you say who's on first.
Then why come up here and ask?
I want to know, what's the pitcher's name?
What's on second?
I don't know. Third base. You got it. Catching?
Yes.
The catcher's name.
Today.
Today. And tomorrow's pitching.
See? You got it?
Yeah, now I got it. St. Louis has got a couple of days on their team, that's all.
Well, I can't change that. All right. What do you want me to do?
You got a catcher?
Yes.
I'm a good catcher, too, you know.
Well, I know that.
I would like to play for the St. Louis team.
Well, I might arrange that.
I would like to catch.
Okay.
Now, I'm being a good catcher. Tomorrow's pitching on the team, and I'm catching.
Yes.
Tomorrow throws the ball, and the guy out bunts the ball.
Yes.
Now, when he bunts the ball, me being a good catcher, I want to throw the guy out at first base. So I pick up the ball, and I throw it to who?
Now, that's the first thing you've said right all day.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Well, that's all you have to do.
It's to throw it to first base.
Yes.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
Who's got it?
Naturally.
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 Okay.
See, now you got it.
So, I pick up the ball and I throw it to naturally.
No, you don't. You throw the ball to first base.
Then who gets it?
Naturally.
Okay.
All right.
I throw it to naturally.
No, you don't. You throw it to who?
Naturally.
Naturally. Say it that way.
That's what I said.
You did not.
I said I throw the ball to naturally.
You don't. You throw it to who?
Naturally.
Naturally.
So I throw the ball to first base and then naturally gets it.
You don't. You throw the ball to first base.
Then who gets it?
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying.
You're not saying that.
I throw the ball to naturally.
You throw it to who?
Naturally.
Naturally. Say it that way.
That's what I'm saying.
Right, now don't get upset.
I throw the ball to first base.
Then who gets it?
He better get it!
All right, now change it easy.
Now I throw the ball to first base. Whoever it is drops the ball, so the guy runs to second. Who picks up the ball and throws it to what? What throws it to, I don't know. I don't know if throws it back to tomorrow. A triple play.
Yeah, it could be.
Another guy gets up, and it's a long fly ball to be caught. Why? I don't know. He's on third, and I don't care.
What was that?
I said, I don't care.
Okay. Well, he's on shortstop.
Yeah!
Win, boo, free fall, who if heaven waits.
Hello, my name is Dawn. It's nice to meet you.
How do you do? My name is Dawn. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Hello, my name is Dawn.
Oh, Velko!
Excuse me?
Velko, Pauline, how are you?
How do you, my name is, sorry.
Oh, Varka, Pauline, Varka.
I'm very sorry to bother you.
Katuba, Dami, Nikto, Ventrika, police.
Really, I think I'm the wrong place.
The wrong place? Oh, that all. You dapa, a direct place. Dimitri, pleasure. Come down, police.
Well, just for a second.
I squeeze you the major. Ah, Zeke.
No, thank you.
Margo. Bell jar, Pauline. What were you?
Bell jar. Is that good day?
Ding! Bell jar, or good day. Eh? Harvard U.
Harvard University?
Ooh, Harvard U.
Howard Hughes.
Ooh, Harvard U.
Oh, how are you?
Ding!
Is this 30 East 7th?
Thirsty Oyster Heaven. Ding!
Sweet 662.
If you, anchor D.
Room B?
Ram U.
The School of Unamunda.
Pets are Unamunda cocker than me. A what can D do for you?
Excuse me?
What can D do for you?
Well, I saw an ad in the newspaper.
Ah, but they're keeping the people?
Well, it says, learn Unamunda, the universal language.
Lick Unamunda, the lingua universal.
The language that will unite all mankind.
The lingua pepper universify all of the peoples in the world. Kristen.
Do you speak English?
English.
Yes, English.
English. Ah, John Cleese.
Yeah, John Cleese.
John Cleese. Alaska, Iago, Paula, do John Cleese.
No John Cleese at all?
One, two, three wolves. Hello. Goodbye. Rice Krispies. Chevrolet. It's cinema. Mock, what's thy business, Sterling?
Well, I wanted to be the first, or among the first, to learn this universal language.
Do art the first they understand. Congratulations. Is that the police forum?
I'm not sure I'm ready to apply just yet.
Dead clink, Pintana.
Dead clink?
What's that thing? We clinks do.
No nabisco?
No nabisco. Clinks do Marie, or Jane, or Barbara, or Betsy, Fred?
Oh, my name.
Exactly. Me clink, me clink.
Me clink.
Arf, Parla.
Me clink, Arf, Don, DeVito.
Don, DeVito. Wasn't harmonic clink? Double do.
D.
Don, DeVito. Squeegees.
I have a slight
stutter.
Yes.
Stutter. Problem in Miss Dahover.
Dahover?
Dahover. The visor? The nozzles? The Volvo? Dahover. Oh. Heads. Heads of Rizzardo. Heads. That's Moto Rizzardo.
Something's wrong?
Do the things. Don. Yellow thing. Don. Vidava?
No.
Don.
Oh, I'm Don and you're Don.
Dang, Art Pizzardo.
Yes, Art Pizzardo.
What's this Minsky? What's this coincidence? What's this paradox?
Well, life is pretty funny sometimes.
The end of the destiny, thinks too.
The end of the destiny?
Nicholas Importante. Argo? Some informations.
Edge.
28.
Von Vett? Slacks?
Female.
Vitamin.
How do you say male?
Aspirin. Occupation.
I'm a word processor.
Ooh, verbo blender.
Is Unamundo very hard to learn?
Easy, eggs, over, easy. The book.
The book.
The book.
Oh, book.
The book. The rumba. The vals. The Isidora. Cha, da cha cha, da cha cha cha! Ah, Braga, Braga, Sonia, Braga! Iago, Victoria Shakespeare, Enta, Unamunda.
You're translating Shakespeare into Unamunda?
Pursuit, Nintendo. Na Rosa, Pollyanna Clink, Hovopso Pink. Balloon filet?
Yes, Bonzo?
Bonanza.
Bonanza.
Mokvist, Pop Lumen Trip Yandra, Fensra, Shient. Earth and Oyster, Pop Juliet, of Sun. Video Falling, Unamunda, Earth and Lingua, Supringa. Amamor.
It's strange how much I understand.
Natural to Mississippi Mente. But the other peoples in the world. All of the peoples in the universe. Cargo of strong and their hearts. At that strong earth. Unamunda!
So, lingua is language.
Exacto.
I see. And is...
Earth.
Was is?
Birth.
Had been?
Long of birth.
And will be?
Birth. Earth was birth. Pasta, prison, a furniture dances. Aclara?
Clara.
Schumann.
Well, Mr.
Finnegan.
Mr.
Finnegan.
What kind of name is that?
Finish.
Well, Mr.
Please, thank me, Dawn.
Well, I'd love to learn Unamunda. I mean, if it's not too expensive.
$500.
$500?
Cash.
$500 is a lot of money.
Calamari, Fallen, calamari. La payola. Ooh, si, smart, importante.
I don't have much money.
Ooh, dump of bonanza girls. Yabba dabba.
And I do have a slight
stutter.
So it's always been hard for me to talk to people. In fact, most of my life has been very long. Pause.
Cure the magia. Mok no desperanto funny, for he lit Unamunda. Ooh, tongue stepper.
I wouldn't stutter.
Ooh.
At all.
Absolutely loop.
But you see, just because I'm silent doesn't mean I've nothing to say.
Charisma.
I mean, a tuning fork. It's silent until you touch it. But then it gives off a perfect A. Tap one tuning fork. And you can start up a whole orchestra. And if you tap that tuning fork anywhere in the whole world, it still gives off that perfect A. It's like this little piece of metal which has all this beautiful sound trapped inside of it.
Oh, for individual. That's so quality. Ooh, I've been this.
But you see, Mr. Finnegan.
And again.
I don't think language is just music. I think language is the opposite of loneliness. And if everyone in the world spoke the same language, who would be lonely?
Charisma.
I just don't think English is my language, since it only makes people laugh at me. Makes me...
lonely.
Dang, very lonely. So will you teach me Unamunda? I have a little bit of money saved up.
For Lane DeVito, that's of Mandy, deep sea countries.
I'll pay. Y'all go cargo.
Deep sea cow, for Lane.
I'll work really hard.
Let's do scoop.
Scoop means what?
Thing.
Can I scoop? Mucho.
Gonna say it in Navanya. Doritus. Bogo de Zitfels. Are Fredley?
Yes, I'm Radley.
Rosa Lachambuli. Concentrieren, concentrieren. Lachstoffhuber, Lachstoffhuber, Lachstoffhuber. Echo me. Stick.
Stick.
Ja.
Ja.
Du.
Du.
And.
Du. Squeegees.
Did they have the problem, my foiling?
Let me begin again, Mr. Finnan again. See? I said your name. I must be getting better.
Okinochki. Father Pentis. Ja.
Ja.
Du.
Du.
N.
Di. Di.
Da.
Da.
Wop.
Wop.
Dubli.
Dubli.
Day.
Day.
Dabba?
Yabba dabba do!
Testicle!
Al dante?
Small testicle.
Ya do walk and do we day.
Do da,
do da. Ya do wop and do we day.
I do da day. Day! Oh, bling bling, my eyes are blinging!
Riddly dee?
Riddly dee! Quisley!
How do you say?
Howard Johnson.
Howard Johnson to have.
Dapa?
So, endapa doodapa deedapa.
Ding!
Endapa doodapa deedapa.
Ding!
Endapa doodapa deedapa day!
Ding! Bling! Bling! Coin caviar! Scoop the guan.
That's scoop of doodoo!
Oh, double scoop!
This is fun!
And so this is fun?
Fantastico!
If anything is on the cake! Deanda.
Deanda.
De Palma.
De Palma.
Da Vinci.
Da Vinci.
De Niro.
De Niro.
De Bamba.
De Bamba.
De Jamba.
De Jamba.
De Jamboree! Hey! Braga, Sonia, Braga!
Minestrone, Minestrone. Howard Johnson, little.
Deeply.
Howard Johnson, big.
Wow!
Argo.
Diddlyanda?
Yada dapa diddlyanda, dusa dupa dapa diddlyanda.
Dusa dapa diddly bop?
Ooh, I have a scoop of bop to wow! Yo, video, yeah, it's up. You're part of Unamunda.
Ah, A-plus, falling A-plus.
Oh my gosh!
What's the matter, Stabby?
No tongue stopper, no problem with the Hoover.
Ah, what diddly I tell ya?
Goodbye, English, Beljar, Unamunda.
Dawn.
My Avalor.
Please, pulling the veto.
Do gave know me a beautiful birth gone, a lingua, at frontier de eternity. Yago parla osolio miento unamunda.
Osolio miento?
Absolutely, thanks to you.
Pulling the veto, that could be one poco bizarro.
Mark, de Paola.
De Paola?
De Gale from Lesson.
A moment, chance.
Let me get the Gale from the hamburger.
The hamburger?
Hamburger! That's all the girl you got at me. Cheer! Nellie Gibson, rest in the Morgan.
I can't take your money, Don.
Squeegee?
I said, I can't take your money.
Do Carla John Cleese?
Actually, I do speak a little John Cleese.
Mock do perlet perfume!
Well, I have been practicing for a while, and anyway, I don't think I mentioned that the first lesson was free.
Mafia von Topago.
But I don't want you to von Topago.
What's the mattress? Cheer, it's yours.
I can't take it.
Porky.
Because I can't.
Not Porky.
Because it's a fraud.
Squeegee?
Unamunda is a fraud.
A Freud?
You think Unamunda a fraud?
Ooh, Baba Gabba!
A con game, a swindle, a parlor trick!
No Crayola!
Believe it, Don, I should know. After all, I'm the one who invented it. I mean, granted, it's not a very good con, since you're the only other person that can walk him through that door. And I'm not a very good con man, since I'm refusing to take your very generous money. But I can't stand the thought of you walking out there saying, Velko, a bel jar, how good you? And having people laugh at you. I swear, Don, I swear I didn't want to hurt you. How could I? How could anybody? Your beautiful heart, it shines out of you like a beacon. And then there's me. a total fraud. I wish I could lie in a thousand languages and say it wasn't true, but I'm sorry, Don. I am so, so sorry.
Not Forrest.
Will you stop?
Unamundo art the lingua universal.
But you and I are the only peoples in the world who speak it.
Do the others.
Who? What others?
Don, if you and I can speak this lingua suprema, anybody can. Everybody will. This isn't just a language. This isn't just a room. This is the Garden of Eden. And you and I are coming up for names for a whole new world. I was so...
happy. I know... so was I.
For Zapdo.
I was happy.
And why?
I don't know.
Because du apia parla da dentica linguini.
All right. So, maybe we do speak the same language. But it's nonsense.
Ooh.
Gibberish.
Ooh.
Double talk.
Don, the lingua we parla is amamor.
Amamor?
Unamundamor. Nalgo arc amorphismit du.
Amorphous?
Polymorphous.
But... Verismo?
Civilismo.
But how? I mean...
Diana di destino.
Are you sure?
The proof is in the pudding. When you free fall...
Fine, if...
heaven...
wait.
Diana.
So, you forgive me?
For making me happy? Yeah, I forgive you.
Diana, I experience this!
Diana.
Anda.
Diploma. Is this the school of Unamundo?
Thank you!
I know what you guys are thinking. You're looking at me and you're saying to yourself, average guy, normal human being, nothing out of the ordinary. Well, that's what I thought too for lots of years. And boy, was I wrong. Now I look back and I think, I always really knew the truth about myself underneath. It's like I would wake up in the morning and I would look at myself in the mirror and I get this weird feeling like, what I was looking at wasn't really what I was looking at. Or else I'd be standing at a crowd of people at a party. And then suddenly I get this weird feeling like I was standing in a huge empty space and there wasn't anybody around me for miles. Episodes of fascination, if you know that beautiful word. And then one day I had what you call a mystical experience. I was walking down Lex over in the 30s when I passed by this office supply shop. Just a crummy little place. But I turn and I look and I see an Olivetimoto 250 electric typewriter. Are you familiar with the Olivetti 250 model? Have you seen the old Olivetti 250? Well, let me tell you, it is sublime. The lines, the shape, the slant of the keyboard, it's all there. It's a thing of beauty. Anyway, I'm looking at this thing, and it's like I recognize it from someplace. It's like looking at family somehow. Like I'm staring at some long-lost older brother for the first time. And then I realize, that's me. That's me right there. That's exactly how I feel like on the inside. The same lines, the same shape, the same aesthetic. And what I realized was, I'm a typewriter. No, really, guys. I'm a typewriter. All those years, I thought I was a human being on the inside, when in reality, I was actually an Olivetti 250 with automatic correctability. The worst part about this is, I can't even type. Problem is, guys, it can be a lonely thing being a typewriter, especially in a world of human beings. And now here I am, every day being replaced by word processors. Who needs a typewriter anymore? I finally figure out what I really am. I'm an antique already. Plus, there's my love life, which is problematical to say the least. The difficulties involved in a typewriter finding a suitable partner in this part of town are quite prodigious, as you can imagine. But at least I understand why I've always loved touch. Being touched and touching. Being touched is the nature and purpose of typewriters. That's how we express ourselves and the human friend along with us. Hands on the keyboard and the right touch. Fire away. Yeah. Look at his hands. They're practically the first thing I notice. A nice soft shape with fingers, good manicure, soft skin, no hangnails. I'm not finger fetishist or anything, you understand? It's just... Oh, you know, you've got a pretty nice pair of hands there yourself. That's what I noticed. That's why I stepped over here to talk to you. You know, I know this all sounds pretty loony and all, but I feel like I could just trust you, you know? Wait, what? I beg your pardon? I don't understand. You're not a real girl? Sure, you're a girl. You're a beautiful girl. You're actually a sheet of paper? Huh. 10-pound bond? Ivory tinted. Oh, pure cotton fiber. Nice to meet you.
While the moon comes up.
Well, give me a break. Just look at your watch.
All right. It is currently 7:15 and 17 seconds.
Let's subtract 15 seconds to adjust for operator error, shall we?
What do I care, Scotty? I mean, really.
All right. Hey, the first 30 seconds or so are easy. Just relax. Cage yourself.
You're weird, Ed.
Adjusted time from start.
23 seconds.
Okay. Alright. Now, I want you to imagine you're in a movie of the week disaster film with Jennifer Lawrence. You are underwater in a nuclear submarine. Jennifer is trapped in the compartment where Polaris missiles are armed and ready to fly. You gotta hold your breath long enough to get in there, disarm 6 missiles, save Jennifer, and save the world from nuclear holocaust. Got that? Go for it. Laser beams enter the room. And you are hiding in a pile of dirty laundry.
No.
One breath out of you, and you'll feel the cold steel of their bayonets. Not bad, huh?
Shaking like that?
Oh, differences in temperature, like the atmosphere glare, distorts the airwaves.
No.
not the moon. A.
Somebody's shaking a little.
Look, the bridge is up.
What?
Of his nose. Bridge is up, you get it?
I just hope he doesn't, pass out or anything. I mean, what if he hyperventilates in reverse? What if he forgets how to breathe?
It took the genetic ancestors of Ed Carmichael billions and billions of years to learn to use their lungs. Even Ed couldn't screw all that up in 3 minutes. Time.
1 minute and 38 seconds.
And the boy is sweating bullets. Now look, Ed, I know you're gonna love this one. It is 1969, and you are president of your university's SDS. The anti-war protest seems to be coming along just fine. When... tear gas! The pigs have brought in the tear gas! One whiff and you'll be reduced to a slobbering flower child! You gotta hold your breath long enough to break into the dean's office! Now go for it!
Thank you. ever up on stage.
Let's go,
us, even though,
tired.
And then we want to thank Mr. Godfrey for putting up with us. And we want to give a really big thank you to Miss Barber for taking this on when no one else wanted to, and for sticking with it even though a lot of people dropped out, and putting up with us.
Everyone for coming. It's really nice to have the support of the community. We really appreciate it. I hope y'all have a great weekend.